former slave, Harriet Tubman, used the Underground Railroad to help more than 300 African Americans escape from slavery from 1850 to 1863. The Underground Railroad was composed of escape routes used to free African Americans from slavery, and Tubman used it to explore escape methods and routes to freedom. She and her network of collaborators also encountered new ideas and a system of people devoted to being free. Their work led to the short-term impact of freeing more than 300 slaves and getting more abolitionists to help along the Underground Railroad. The long-term impact was taking a step towards abolishing slavery and creating a country that values equality. One of the great struggles and highly debated topics of the 1800s was slavery. Slavery was very common around the world, and 20-30% of society was enslaved. Defined as the relationship between domination and power, slavery was when one person owned another person. American slavery began in Jamestown, Virginia in 1619 and ran throughout the colonization of America through 1865. Between 1777 and 1827, all of the northern states had abolished slavery because in the north, slavery was seen as evil. However, slavery in the southern United States increased. Now, why did it increase? The cotton gin, which was a revolutionary mechanical device in which the cotton was separated from the seed, was the reason why. After the cotton gin was invented by Eli Whitney in 1793, the North needed more and more cotton for the factories, and so the plantations needed more and more slaves since the demand was so high because cotton products were cheaper and they could make mass quantities of it with almost no labor. But the real question is, how can something so big and so powerful like slavery be abolished? Well, there were many significant figures who saw slavery as wrong and decided to do something about it. Among those people was Harriet Tubman. Harriet Tubman was a fugitive slave who, after escaping, came back to the plantations to rescue more enslaved people. William Lloyd Garrison, a fellow abolitionist, informally named her Moses because she was like Moses to people, and it turned into a well-known nickname. In order to not get captured, Tubman used a system known as the Underground Railroad. Despite its name, the Underground Railroad was not an actual railroad. This system was a network of safe houses where slaves could get sleep, food, and kind treatment on their way from the south to the north. The fugitives would move from safe house and hide there. The slaves needed a method to finding the safe house. To do this, they followed the North Star. Though Harriet Tubman saved many people, she also encountered different views and beliefs. Many people, including slaves and abolitionists, made her struggles with escaping easier. But people with different beliefs, such as pro-slavery, made her struggles just that much harder. The abolitionists impacted and influenced Tubman's success on the railroad immensely. The abolitionists put up slaves in safe houses and tried to make sure that they were safe from the racists. Even though Tubman had many people on her side, she also had many that weren't. The slave owners and other whites, which were pro-slavery, threatened her safety and the safety of other slaves when coming to the North. Since they were white and pro-slavery, she knew that in the Southern government, they had more power over her because they could whip or kill her and her fugitive slaves.
Rescuing slaves became more and more difficult because the Fugitive Slave Act was passed in 1850. This act meant that any slave caught in the North would need to be brought back to the South. Slave owners weren't even allowed to free their own slaves even though they were technically their property. A little ways after this, in about 1851, slave capturers started to look for Tubman. Rescuing slaves was a huge risk. At one point, there was a $40,000 reward for Tubman's capture. Some slaves even tried to return to their plantations and give up along the way, but if they did, everyone would be captured. Tubman often carried around a gun with her to threaten these slaves. She's known for saying, "Be free or die." This is also why she never lost a passenger throughout all of her missions. Many other less-known people also helped, even though it could have led to loss of business. The safe houses all made sure that every slave was taken care of with clothes and food before allowing them to continue on their rough journey. The women made clothes for slaves, which was very beneficial because most of the journey was rainy and cold. Abolitionists, white or black, helped Tubman because of how poorly treated slaves were. At about the age of 10 or 12, slaves would begin to do hard work in the fields. They would harvest many different crops such as cotton, which became an important product in helping the South as well. The slaves lived in cluttered cabins called the quarters. Sickness was also very common, and the slave infant death was double the death of the white infants of free people. Tubman herself was half starved by her owner. Since this happened to slaves, some rebelled and stole food. Some even ruined tools and crops. One man in particular, Nat Turner, led a revolt in which he and some other slaves went and killed over 50 white people. They were caught and killed. If a slave disobeyed their owner, they would also have severe punishments such as beatings and death. Though there were quite a few abolitionists, there were also people who believed that the wealth and power of the South depended on slavery. Slavery was seen as a good thing to some people because it was a source of cheap labor. The slaves would work in houses or on rice, cotton, sugar, or corn plantations. The owners would also sell slaves for money, causing them to be separated from their families. Getting separated was the reason Tubman escaped. Harriet Tubman started off being born and raised in Dorchester County, Maryland. She was very close to her father growing up, who taught her many skills that little did she know she would use in the outside world in just a couple years. When Harriet was young, she was hit in the head with a metal weight, which influenced her life severely, causing her to have seizures and to randomly fall asleep. Harriet escaped from Maryland at a young age, and when she was going into Pennsylvania, she had to cross the Mason-Dixon line, which was a line that separated Maryland and Pennsylvania, but was also the limit of slave-owning states until the North. She went to Philadelphia because there was a large population of abolitionists and African Americans. Tubman journeyed to the South after escaping about 19 times to rescue slaves. Tubman also explored many different methods of escape. One of these methods was dressing up in disguises. The conductors, who were people that helped along the Underground Railroad, also went to great extremes in helping the slaves. One man, Henry Box Brown, was shipped to the North in a box. The Underground Railroad did not always go to Canada, but was rerouted there due to slave capturers. To be able to have so many conductors and supporters, the Anti-Slave Society explored ways of getting their society known. They printed out 10,000 copies of an anti-slavery speech. One abolitionist in particular, William Lloyd Garrison, created a newspaper named The Liberator. It was first published in 1831 and ran on for about 34 years. Another significant figure who was the first one to introduce Tubman to the anti-slavery movement in 1849 was William Still. This man interviewed fugitives on their lives. Not only individuals were a part of this, but so were specific states. Tubman had many short-term impacts in the 1800s. She rescued over 300 slaves, and her work with the Underground Railroad helped Tubman spy on the Confederate troops with the Union because she knew so many routes that the South was using and helped the Union with tactics. Harriet Tubman did not only impact the lives of the 1800s, but through her actions with the Underground Railroad and even just in the community, she has helped our society today and become a country that truly believes in equality. She did many things, including writing a book called Scenes in the Life of Harriet Tubman, with the help of Sarah Bradford, an author. This book helped empower women through women's suffrage and also helped inspire slaves to become free, and it is still inspiring people today to stand up for what they believe in. Not only the book helped empower women, since Tubman was a woman and in her time period, women had few rights, all of her great work showed that women are able to accomplish great things. The female anti-slavery groups encouraged activism and political thinking by women.
And I think her legacy is what we all feel today. The impact of what she did has become even more important to us today, I think, than when she died back in 1913. Her constant pursuit of freedom and equality inspired many people, and it still inspires people today.
Even after all of her struggles in life, Tubman could have given up, but she didn't. Using exploration and encounter, she helped our countries take a step into becoming equal. Our country still has unfinished work to do around racism and the agreement of treating everyone equally. But Harriet Tubman took a step forward for us and had a significant role in abolishing slavery.